Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha. Today we are going to discuss the topic which is usually confused by many persons, not only by the layman who doesn't know law, but also by many law students as well by the faculty members. Although if you look at that topic, it is very simple in nature and it is simple to understand. I will try to explain the difference in a very simple manner and hope you will like it. So today we are going to discuss the topic, what is the difference between culpable homicide and murder? That is section 299 and 300 of the Indian Penal Code. Before starting the difference between culpable homicide and murder, let's understand the meaning of homicide. Now, homicide is derived from the Latin word. If you break that word in homo and side, homo means men, and side means to kill or cut. That means I kill or I cut. So when a man is cut or man is killed, it is called as homicide. You might have heard pesticide. Pesticide is when pest is killed. That means pesticide. Similarly, when homo, man is killed, it is homicide. So it is as simple as I have explained. Now, if we talk about culpable, now, homicide can be a lawful homicide or unlawful homicide. You might be surprised, but whether a man can be killed or homicide could be lawful? So yes, it is lawful. That has been mentioned under general exception in IPC only. I have already made two videos of general exception. That is justifiable general exception and excusable general exception. That's why I'm not going to give the details of general exception in this video. You may see that particular video for the details. So this is called the meaning of homicide, that when man is killing, that could be either lawful or unlawful. So when it is lawful, it comes under general exception, and when it is unlawful, it comes under the section which we are going to discuss in this video. Now the meaning of culpable homicide. So culpable means the person who is having a guilty mind or he can be blameworthy. You might have heard the word culprit. So culprit means the person who have committed something illegal or unlawful act. So if homicide is in a form of an unlawful act, or unlawful means or illegal act, that comes under culpable homicide, which is punishable under IPC. That has been discussed under section 299 of IPC. So section 299 of the Indian Penal Code states that whoever causes death by doing an act with the intention of causing death, or with the knowledge that he is likely by such act to cause death, commits the offense of culpable homicide. Now we have already looked at the definition of culpable homicide. Usually people think that the difference between the culpable homicide and murder is that there is an intention of murder or to kill someone is in murder, and when there is no intention, it is culpable homicide. But this is wrong, because in both, whether it is culpable homicide or murder, there is always an intention to kill someone. Then what is the difference?
Murder is defined under section 300 of the Indian Penal Code. According to this act, culpable homicide is considered as murder if the act is committed with an intention to cause death. Secondly, if the act is done with the intention of causing such bodily injury which the offender has knowledge that it would result in death. Thirdly, the person has the knowledge that his act is dangerous and would cause death or bodily injury but still commits the act. This would amount to murder.
The definition of murder also states that there is an intention to murder someone or to cause such a bodily injury that the person will die. Now we have to look, before explaining these things, I have to explain you exactly the meaning of mens rea, because here mens rea plays very, very important role. and you have to understand mens rea, because mens rea and actus reus, these are the special elements of crime which plays very important role to frame a criminal responsibility or criminal liability. And on the basis of the criminal liability only, any person can be framed as culprit. Understand mens rea. Although I have already made a video, Elements of Crime, which is my first video in which the detail of all the four elements of crime has been explained. That is human body, mens rea, actus reus and injury. But in short, if we have to understand the meaning of mens rea, first of all, it is necessary to understand that mens rea also contain three parts. The first one is motive, second is intention, and third is knowledge. That means the combination of motive, intention and knowledge will amount as mens rea. Now, what is the meaning of motive? Motive means what is the reason behind committing any crime, and that reason is not sufficient to frame a criminal responsibility. So the reason could be anything. It could be jealousy, it could be revenge, it could be lust, it could be accident, it could be mental illness, anything. So the reason is always there to commit any crime. So that is the reason which is called as motive. The second thing is intention. Now, intention is what exactly a person is committing. Now, how that particular motive is given away. That means if the person is having a jealousy, so he wants to either kill that person or give a grievous hurt or hurt or anything else. So that particular offense is the intention of that person. So out of revenge, a person wants to kill that person. Here, revenge is motive and intention it kill. Now, in intention only, the killing is also, what are the ways, what are the mode he has taken to kill the other person. Now, that mode of killing that person could be either he is going to give poison, either he is going to give a blow on his body with such a gravity that the person is killed. Even he is going to do an accident of that particular person or any other mode in which there is a sufficient amount of gravity has been used that the person is killed. Now the third thing is knowledge. Now knowledge is whether the person who is committing that particular crime or offense, whether that person is having a knowledge that the way, the intention which he has used or the crime which he is committing, whether he is well aware about the consequence of that particular act. If he is having a knowledge that if I'm going to commit that particular thing, that the person is going to die definitely, then it comes under mens rea, that is guilty mind. So it is important to understand and to make a combination of all the three things, which is a part of mens rea, that is motive, intention and knowledge. But that mens rea is also not sufficient. After that mens rea, there must be some act, that is actus reus. So when there is mens rea, and on the basis of that particular mens rea, any illegal act has been committed, that could be a sufficient element of crime. So the first difference between culpable homicide and murder has been mentioned under the definition only about the act. In culpable homicide, it is written that whenever there is an act, whereas in murder it is mentioned whenever there is the act. Now this an act and the act itself is the difference between culpable homicide and murder, which clearly shows the intention and the consequence of a particular act. If there is an act, and means there could be any sort of act which is likely to commit murder or which is sufficient to commit murder. So if it is likely to commit murder, that means any such act which may commit a murder or which may kill someone, that comes under an act which has been mentioned under culpable homicide. Whereas if we talk about murder, it has been clearly mentioned that any of the act. The act means when there is specific, the act is specific in nature. That act has been committed, which is sufficient in nature to kill someone. So the first difference is about an act, which could be any act, and the act, which is specific in nature to cause such type of bodily injury, which could kill any person. Now, if we have to elaborate the meaning of that particular act, it is again that will make out the second difference. In culpable homicide, it is mentioned that an act could likely to commit homicide or to kill someone. Whereas if we talk about murder, there is a sufficient amount of act has been done which will definitely going to kill someone. Say for an example, if a person wants to kill another person with an intention to kill that person, with an intention to give such a severe bodily injury that the person will be killed. But the weapon which he has used is stick. No matter he might be using that stick in his head, which is considered as a very delicate place where the person may die. But here may die. It is not necessary that the person will definitely die. So if he is using stick to kill that person with an intention also, with the intention of to give bodily injury in such a way that the person is going to kill also, but still, if the person has used a stick, that particular thing which is likely to kill, then it could be culpable homicide. Whereas if we talk about the sufficient anything, any weapon which is sufficient in nature to kill someone, like pistol or revolver. If the person is using a revolver to kill someone, that means he is definitely, that is sufficient enough, that particular the act is sufficient enough to kill that person. So that is sufficiently, which is used in murder. So that is also one difference. The next is degree of probability of causing death. Now, degree of probability of causing death is on the basis of, we can take the example to understand it clearly. Now, if A is having a knowledge that his neighbor is a heart patient, and if any bad news will be given to him, then he is definitely going to die. This has been stated by his doctor only. So with an intention to cause death of the neighbor, A went to the neighbor and he gave the news of death of his son. And on the consequence of that, his neighbor dies. This may amount to culpable homicide, because here the degree of probability will be considered at the time of the trial. Whether that news is sufficient in nature to cause death or not, what is the degree of that particular news, that will be evaluated. So it may be culpable homicide. But if we take another example, suppose if anyone is on ventilator in the hospital, and if anyone with an intention to cause death of that particular person, if he turn off all the system of the ventilator, that particular patient or person will definitely going to die. So here degree is sufficient. So though there is no probability, here the probability is sufficient to cause death. So that makes out the difference whether it is culpable homicide or whether it is murder. Now the next distinction is on the basis of the gravity. Now how much gravity has been used to kill another person, that also is a major distinction between culpable homicide and murder. For example, if the person is using a stick and he is hitting another person with an intention to kill that person only, but stick is not sufficient or not having such gravity that person will be, definitely there will be death. On the contrary, if a person who is giving a blow to another person, he is having an idea that the person whom he wants to kill is having such a delicate or a injury at some of the body part, where even if a simple blow it will be given, he is going to die. And with an intention to kill that person, if he gives a blow on that particular part, with the consequence if person dies, that will amount to murder. The distinction between culpable homicide and murder has been clearly stated first in Rek versus Govinda case. So let's discuss that case also, so that you can understand the clear distinction between the two. In this case, the accused has knocked his wife down, put one knee on her chest and struck her two or three violent blows on the face with the closest fist, producing extravasation of blood on the brain, and she died in consequence, either on the spot or very shortly afterwards. There being no intention to cause death and the bodily injury not being sufficient in ordinary course of nature to cause death, the accused was liable for culpable homicide, not amounting to murder. So in this case also, the blow has been used by the husband. And in ordinary case, no blow can be sufficient enough to kill any other person. So that is the case which makes out the difference between the culpable homicide and murder. So I think you understand the difference. So let's sum up. So the difference between culpable homicide and murder could be made first on the basis of, if it is culpable homicide, it is an act, which could be any act. If it is murder, it is the act, that means a specific act which could cause death. Now, in culpable homicide, it is likely to commit death. That means any act which is likely to cause death. And if we talk about murder, it is sufficient to cause death. Now, the third difference is on the basis of the gravity. If the gravity is sufficient enough to cause death, then it is murder. But if it is not sufficient enough to cause death, but death happened, then it is culpable homicide. Then the fourth difference is on the basis of the degree of probability of causing death, or degree of probability of death. That means which type of degree which has been used, which has a probability to cause death. If it is less, then it is culpable homicide. If it is more, then it is murder. I hope you now understand the difference between culpable homicide and murder. If you like my video, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Social media platform with the name of Law Colloquy, that is on Instagram, on FB page, on Twitter and LinkedIn. We are also having our website, that is priyasepaha.com, where we used to share articles, blogs, news, video and many other things. That's all for today. See you soon. Bye bye.